Welcome on in, everybody. So I have been playing a lot of Amazon's New World during the preview test period that's been going on for this past week or so, and I've been doing a lot of PvP in New World. It has been a lot of fun. So much fun, in fact, that once I turned on PvP mode in this game, which is a toggleable option, you don't have to have it on all the time, I literally just left it on for the entirety of my remaining gameplay. I even keep my character in PvP mode when I'm out gathering resources, just in case I can run into a fight. Now, PvP in New World is faction-based, so you pick a faction pretty early on in the game, deciding which of the three different teams you want to be on, and then while you're out in the world, if you have PvP toggled on, you can be attacked by any of the other two factions. This is very similar to the system that ESO has when we're out fighting in Cyrodiil. However, this PvP system is active everywhere at all times when you toggle it on. So New World essentially has the option for true open world PvP. And I've been doing a lot of that. I really enjoy being able to just fight people anywhere, and it adds a lot of excitement to the game for activities that would normally maybe be not so exciting, like going out to hunt some bison, but knowing that somebody or some people could jump me at any time. Now, there is a PvP quest system that gives you a lot of experience and other rewards for doing certain quests while having PvP enabled, but I would love to see a little bit more incentive in this game to keep PvP toggled on. Maybe just in general, having a 10% bonus to XP gained and resources collected could be something to help incentivize people to keep that PvP toggled on more often. That being said, I'm not sure where the sweet spot would be here between incentivizing people to PvP and making people feel like they have to PvP in order to be effective. But either way, they do have some incentive now, and it helps create that high-risk, high-reward environment that has made open world so exciting for me. Now let's talk a bit about how combat feels in PvP. Keep in mind that I am very new to the game still. There are a lot of things that I am not aware of / don't know how to do yet. Plus my aim is hilariously bad. And it's not just me, there are a lot of other people out there that are not aware of different things that you can do too. So I think that as it sits right now, it'll be tough for anyone to really determine what the meta will be or what's OP and what's not, just because general combat knowledge hasn't been fully explored yet. You get a lot of variety in what you want to do in combat. If you choose ranged weapons, of course, aim becomes very important for you, and if you're using more melee weapons, things like movement and spacing become more important, as well as blocking, attacking, and just timing your attacks. I think the fact that you have to aim every single attack is a huge win for this game. If you didn't have to aim the attacks and you just locked on with a tab target, very similar to other MMOs, I think it would really take away from what makes PvP fun, at least just combat in general fun in this game. I know this sounds weird, but it's nice to actually miss your shot, because if you miss your shot, it means that you can improve in your gameplay and continue to get better and enjoy more and more of the game. And if you're playing the tab target version of a game, well, essentially your aim is perfect every time, so it doesn't require you to really practice or anything in order to make that shot. I guess the runaround of this argument here is that the combat in this game is very skill-based. You have to play well and you have to make good decisions. Even though there is very little animation canceling in the game, combat still feels fast because you still have to aim everything. And not only that, but you have to pay very close attention to what your opponents are doing because they deal a lot of damage to you and it's very hard to heal yourself in an active fight. The way that combat is designed in this game, it is fairly cutthroat, and the decisions you make even at the beginning of a fight could determine the end outcome big time. Now, in PvP, you can have 3 active food buffs up at all times, which I highly recommend you do have, simply because your health will not regenerate naturally unless you have a food buff active. And then you also can drink potions in the course of a fight, but it holds your character very still when you drink a potion, so you essentially make yourself very susceptible. So, let's look at a fight here and talk a little bit about it, commentating the fight as we go. So I have 2 green players on top of me here, and they're just running up behind me. They had been chasing me for a little bit, but I moved to this spot here because I wanted a little bit better terrain to take the fight. Here I just use my staff teleport to teleport around and try to get a big smack with my big bow AoE. It shoots 5 arrows, so if I hit someone with all 5 arrows at close distance, it does an insane amount of damage, and that's effectively my best kill move on this build. There you see this guy is under attack from the tiger, and we managed to smack him with the bow AoE to finish him off there. And normally when you kill a player, they're in that down state. He just respawned and gave up before I had the chance to finish him off. He could have waited on the ground for the chance of getting revived by his friendly player, but he decided not to continue the fight here. So these enemy tigers, man, this thing has some serious wander range too. I mean, this guy will follow you a few hundred meters away from where he originally sits. So we're basically just gonna do this fight with the tiger attacking us. There you see, I cut it really close with the staff teleport and right away into the potion. I think that the life staff is an absolute must have in PvP right now. And that's the only weapon I'll say is a must have. And there's one reason. That teleport is a 40 meter teleport, and it is so hard to heal yourself in this game. It's the only reliable way to break distance from your opponent. The bow dodge roll does add movement speed after we roll, and you can see how easily we can kite this guy in heavy armor. As long as we just keep rolling around him, we can keep pelting him with arrows. But that life staff teleport allows you to break a huge amount of distance for a period of time from your opponent. If you don't have the teleport and your opponent does, not only will you not be able to get away from them, but they will always keep up with you too. So yeah, not having a life staff in PvP kind of leaves you a sitting duck in my opinion, at least for world PvP. Now I managed to get a great connection on that guy with the spray shot, and I put a lot of damage into him, but he is very, very chunky. This guy is quite a bit higher level than me too. I'm gonna be honest, a lot of people that I fought were higher level than me. I did my best to put together the best PvP build that I could. I'm very, very squishy. You can see this tanky guy actually taking some chunks out of me with his attacks there. And I just go for a teleport again with the resto staff. He's really smart though. He knows that I'm faster with the bow and that his best bet with his teleport is to wait until I use mine so he can at least stay on top of me. And yeah, this guy has got some chunk, man. He's healing over time with that health regen too. We take a nasty smack from him there and right away we roll out of it. A lot of issues that I see players having in this game is getting stuck in stun chains, and I think that's because they're playing the heavier armor specs. They find themselves blocking attacks, running out of stamina, and then just getting stuck in a never-ending stun chain from someone's light attacks. Here you can see I'm actively seething my weapon while we fight this guy, and the reason I do that is because when you seethe your weapon, your stamina will restore a little bit faster, or start to restore a little bit faster than if you keep your weapon out. There you see again, I hit him with a nice Glock, and we get caught with our stamina down, and we eat a few attacks in a row. That's something that I can't stress enough, is be very aware of how much stamina you have. There you see I tried to go for the bow attack again, but I opt out of doing it because we're low on stamina, and that means that we'll even pull the arrow back slower on our bow. So I decide to opt out of continuing that attack, and I switch to my gun here and I throw the bomb on the ground. I didn't really mean to do that, but it did hit him, and then I go for the play dead off the gun skill there. That actually refreshes all my cooldowns, so I'm able to get my bow ability back and just quickly hit him with another smack there, and he finds himself again fairly low HP, and I'm pretty high HP here, so I will be able to keep the pressure up on him. And we're gonna try to put some arrows into him as he just chugs the potions. And here I think you see just the fact that I'm a little out leveled. He's quite a bit higher level than me, quite a lot chunkier than me, and my attacks are not hitting him for a lot of damage. And yeah, I think that has a lot to do straight up with the gear. Doing a good job fighting this guy. He's not landing a lot of attacks on us. And there you see, we get a nice connection with the bow again. He goes for the hop and we hit him with that arrow. We're gonna shoot him in the kneecap to finish him off. So I think that fight there dragged out a bit longer than it should have because neither of us were running a stun, and having a stun in that situation would have helped both of us put the other opponent down. There you see just how much damage my bow shot can do if we hit someone who's not really tanky. I mean, we can almost one-shot them with this bow attack. I also think that having smoother transitions between your different states would be nice for this game too. And I'm talking about something like pulling our arrow out, taking a shot, and just being able to roll a little bit sooner than we are. And of course there are some bugs in this game, namely with the world building is where I run into issues with PvP and getting stuck in terrain. And there you see, unfortunately, we just get stuck in this little hole and we're not going to be able to get out. I didn't run into this problem a lot, but it is an issue that I am having. There's an option in the game menu to unstuck yourself, but that's not something I'm going to be able to do when I have a player attacking me like this. So there you go, guys. Those are my thoughts on PvP in New World. I've honestly been having a lot of fun playing it, and I would recommend you guys give it a shot if you can get into a beta in the future, or if the game comes out, give it a shot then too. My open world PvP experiences were definitely not limited to small scale fights. I got in some pretty huge scrums outside of cities as well. So there's all kinds of different stuff that can happen in PvP in this game. So that element of never knowing what you're gonna get in PvP is always present, and that helps keep it exciting. Now, if you guys got the chance to play, or if you just have some impressions, I would love to know what you think about PvP in New World, and whether you'd be interested in trying something like this yourself or not. So please let me know down in the comments section below. If you guys enjoyed the video and you want to see some more from me, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I normally create ESO content, but when New World comes out, I will be creating a lot of content for this as well. If you guys want to keep up to date with my shenanigans, you can always give me a follow on Twitter. Check out my Twitch for some live gameplay or just to come and say hi. You can check out my website, ChristopherESO.com, for all of your Elder Scrolls Online PvP build needs. And we are sponsored by What the Fast, their VPN for gamers, and they can give you better ping to your favorite games for the first 30 days. Totally free to sign up, no credit card down in the description below. And then last but certainly not least, a big thank you and a big shout out to all of my patrons on Patreon. Without you guys, I wouldn't be able to do this job, so thank you so much for supporting. I hope that you guys are enjoying some of the New World content. We'll be getting right back into ESO now that the preview is coming to an end. That being said, I hope you guys have a great night, and I'll see you next time. Thank you for tuning in, everybody.